to show you exactly what situation you should and how to cut your shank to a three-quarter. There are certain situations or certain dancers or certain people's feet who they really do need a little bit less of a shank. I am one of them. Brand new shoes, I physically cannot get all the way up onto my platform, and by the time I break them in to the point where I can get all the way up onto my platform, the box is dead. So that's annoying. So my teacher showed me how to do this lots of years ago, and I've been doing it ever since, and it makes a huge difference. There are some dancers who have very high arches who have a similar issue where you know, their shank is very hard and they roll up into their shoe and they snap their shank almost immediately because their foot just bends so much. Sometimes if you have those dancers and you cut their shoe to a three-quarter, that actually makes a huge difference for them because when they roll up onto their shank, the shoe isn't bending as much because there's less shank. And so they're actually able to have their shoes last longer. So again, certain situations, certain dancers, certain feet, don't do this to your shoes unless your teacher tells you to, or unless your shoes are completely worn out and dead, and then you can try it and see if it makes a difference for you or not. Step one is to pull the shank away from the back of the shoe. Now, for some dancers, this is enough. This is all you need to do. So I would definitely try this first. And then when you're done, you want to just quickly slide the shoe onto your foot and prop it up and see if it's going to make a difference in your heel. For me, because of the shape of my foot, my shank is actually just a little bit too long. You can see how it kind of sticks off right there. Ideally, a shank ends like right before the heel. And I'm actually not wearing my toe pads right now, so it would be more like that, but it's still just a little bit too long for me, and you can see how there's this spot right here that I'm not bending at all. So I'm going to cut that off, and it's going to look more like that when I'm done, and it's going to give me that little bit of extra edge I need to get up onto my shoe. So again, start with just pulling the heel off. This glue right here is really difficult to get off. You may need an X-Acto knife or a box cutter. So please, 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 young dancers, again, don't do this without your parents' permission, and please let your dad do it for you, because box cutters are scary. Okay, the next step, if you do decide to go on to the next step, you need a pair of tile cutters, okay? I got these at Walmart probably 10 years ago. They're like 15 bucks, they're not expensive. You can get super sharp ones and it makes it a little bit easier, but you know, they're just very sharp, they're very strong. It's one of the only things I can use to cut my shank. So I'm just quickly gonna slide the shoe back on my foot. I'm going to mark where I want to cut it. Let me make sure you can see this. This is important. Okay. So my shank ends here on my heel, and I want it to end, I'm actually gonna draw on my tights. I want it to end there. Okay, that's where I want my shank to end. So I'm gonna put a little line on my shoe right there at the bottom, and that's where I'm gonna start cutting it off. Just a little bit. And that makes a big difference for me. I actually want just a little bit more. So I'm just going to trim off a little bit extra. Big difference for me. I'm able to get all the way up on my shank. I'll show you the difference with my other shoe that is not cut yet. And my right foot is actually my stronger foot. So you can see I'm definitely much better off with that cut shoe. I actually have a very flat foot, or I was born with a flat foot. Pointe actually stretched my arches out a lot to the point where I deal with a lot of ankle pain and bone on bone grinding, which is not good. So yeah, it really depends on your foot. It really depends on your shoe. Again, check with your teacher. Try it on a pair of dead shoes first. Cut a little bit at a time. And never experiment on a brand new pair of shoes, please. Younger dancers, again, please be careful. Ask a parent to help you out. You know, those tools are very sharp. The box cutter is very easy to hurt yourself with. An X-Acto knife is easy to hurt yourself with. So please be careful and have a parent help you cut your shoes for the first time. Good luck!